Now we may exercise 8.1. We asked to find the area covered in the first quadrant. Exercise 8.6 sum. The given equation find x equal to root 3 by y and the equation of circle x square plus y square equal to 4. It both cover the area in the first quadrant. What is area covered in the first quadrant? The help of line and the circle. Okay. So we first you draw the circle. So circle x square plus y square, there is a square means 4, you can write a 2 square. That same you can write instead of 4 you can write 2 square. Why I asked to write like that? You have to identify the radius equal to 2. They help to identify the radius equal to 2. So if you draw the circle, it passes through the 2 in both axes. So we can draw the circle with the 2 centimeters. That's approximate diagram. So in order to identify where the circle intersect, that point is from 2. So 2, 0. So now we can draw the line x equal to root 3y. X equal to root 3y. So when x equal to 0, y equal to 0. So line passes through the origin. So approximately we can draw the line. So what next, you want to find what is the intersection of that point. Because they asked to find what is the area covered in the first quadrant. If you are able to find the point of intersection, we can draw the line and able to identify what is that particular place. So there are, we can find the required area, first part and second part. Here A1 is there, A2 is there. So you want to find the area of A1 and A2 because there are two conditions. If you use the condition of area between line and curve, we learn next exercise. Now we are going to use how to find the area with the help of x axis or y axis. So up to line, cover the area from that A1. A2, the circle cover the area with the x axis. That's very important. So A1, cover the area with the x axis with the help of line. A2 is the area which cover the help of curve with the x axis. Curve means a circle. So you want, next you want to find what is the point of intersection of line and this circle. So simple, instead of x substitute the value here, root 3y. So from equation 2, instead of x substitute root 3y. So root 3y the whole square plus y square equal to 4. Then 3y square plus y square equal to 4. Then 4y square equal to 4. Then y equal to plus or minus 4, 4 cancel, only become y square. Then y equal to plus or minus 1. If we take y equal to 1, x equal to root 3. So maybe here we take approximately when y equal to 1, x equal to root 3. Okay, y equal to 1, x equal to root 3. If y equal to minus 1, x also will come, minus root 3 will come. So you don't worry about this point of intersection, you need here alone because to find the value here. So just see approximate diagram, don't think we are, 1 is there, so root 3, maybe 1 point something only. So just approximate, that value is root 3. Because here x value is root 3 comma 1, so that value is root 3. Why you want to find the point of intersection, in order to find the limit for A1, it will help. What is the limit for A1? 0 to root 3. What is limit for A2? Root 3 to 2. For that purpose, we are finding the point of intersection root 3 comma 1. So required area. So our required area equal to A1 plus A2. A1 plus A2. What is A2? So A2 limits. A1 limit. A1 limit x equal to 0. X equal to root 3. And A2 limits x equal to root 3 and x equal to 2. So we have limit in x, so function you should be in what? Y. So here x root 3 is there, then y equal to what will come? X by root 3. Okay? So now you want to find required area, integral over the limit, first limit A1 is 0 to root 3. 0 to root 3. Next you want to write here y into dx. Then plus A2. And limit is root 3 to 2, then y into dx. The sum of both, you are able to find the required area in the first quarter. Okay. Now we go and write what is so the required area equal to 0 to root 3. What is the y? From equation 1. So A1 it cover area with the help of line. Okay, so go to equation 1. So here you want to take y alone. So root 3 y is this. Bring the root 3 here. So y equals to x by root 3. So instead of y, you can write x by root 3. Okay, alright, so you put on this root. Right, that will be no problem. So you can understand, I think. So root 3 bring here. So y equal to x by root 3 into dx. Then plus now root 3 to 2. Second one. The A to cover the area with the help of circle. So from the circle you want to find what? Y. So here y square is there. So 4 minus x square. From that we can able to get from equation 2 y square equal to, we have 4 minus x square. Then finally y equal to square root of 4 minus x square. So instead of y here, square root of 4 minus x square into dx. Now integrate together. Always take first part and second part. You can add together also, no problem. So finding area A1 first, then A2. Finally you can add both also, no problem. Now here 1 by root 3 is a constant term. So 1 by root 3, integral of x become x squared by 2. The limit is 0 to root 3. Plus integral of here 4 we can write as a 2 squared. That means a squared minus x squared. So if you instead of 4 you can write 2 squared, then what will happen? Instead of, so 2 squared minus x squared. So a squared minus x squared, integral of square root of a squared minus x squared, it becomes x by 2 square root of 2 squared minus x squared plus a squared by 2 sine inverse of x by a, and a value is here 2. So limit is 0 to 2, sorry, root 3 to 2. Okay, now the 2 you will take outside. So 1 by 2 root 3, instead of x square substitute 3. So root 3 square, then minus lower limit 0 only will come. Okay, now you substitute upper limit and lower limit root 3 plus. When you substitute upper limit 2, instead of x substitute 2, so 2 squared will come, entire value become a 0. So first part 0. Then when you come to here, 2 squared 2, 2 cancel, plus 2 will come. Instead of x substitute 2, it become a sine inverse of 1. Then minus of lower limit value root 3. When you substitute here root 3 by 2. So instead of x substitute root 3, when substitute root 3, 3 will come, so 4 minus 3, 1 will come, so in square root it become 1 will come, then plus again 2 square cancel 2, then sine inverse of root 3 by 2. Now we can minimize the term, 3 square become a 3, so 3 square become a 3, so 3 by 2 root 3 plus sin inverse of 1 pi by 2. Sin inverse of 1 pi by 2. Now the minus multiply inside. So minus root 3 by 2. Then minus 2 sin inverse of root 3 by 2. Okay. Now the root 3, 3 cancel, here root 3 will come. So root 3 by 2 plus 2, 2 cancel. Pi is remaining here, then minus root 3 by 2 minus 2 into sine inverse of root 3 by 2, sine 60 degree root 3 by 2. So 60 degree you write as a pi by 3. Now root 3 that term eliminate. Now we have pi minus 2 by 3, then cross multiply 3 minus 2 pi by 3. Finally we have pi by 3. So the required area is pi by 3 square units.